What's good, YouTube? Skillsmo985 here, welcoming you back to VGC Battlespot Episode 2. In the last episode, you saw I put together a brand new team, and it was amazing. Like, these Pokemon have done, like, they did so much work. So I'm going to do one more battle with this team, then I'll change up. So I need to start actually EV training, like, different members and stuff. So you might see the same members with different things. Who knows? I don't want to just keep bringing the same stuff every single time. But our team is a Salazzle, Katana, Muk. Let's go this again. So we have got, my team is Salazzle, Katana, Muk, Toucanon, Decidueye, and Minior against, oh my god, we have got Decidueye, Feromosa, Greninja, Necrozma, Lapras, and Seeking. Alright, so Necrozma is just Psychic. I think, looking at this team again, I'm going to open Katana Salazzle. Should I bring Muk and Minior? I think Muk and Minior to maybe clear something up afterwards. Yeah, that seems good. So we'll go. Or I could do Salazzle Minior again. I mean, I think Minior gets destroyed if he opens Lapras or Seeking, and he gets hurt with the Feromosa. So yeah, I'm gonna open Katana Salazzle, and then Minior Muk, and we'll see how this goes. The team is quite scary. I've not actually come across a never fought against a Necrozma yet, so it'd be nice to see it even on the screen. So, while this was going on, I got the battle quite quickly. If you're hyped for this and enjoying this kind of content on the channel, and I'm loving doing this series, please leave a like on this video and subscribe if you are new. And if you've got any team suggestions or any, like, oh my god, he's open Feromosa and Necrozma, if you've got any suggestions, please feel free to put them in the comment section below and let me know what you think of my playstyle and all that kind of good stuff. Alright then, so Necrozma and Feromosa, this guy is not messing around. So I'm thinking of just going for protecting Katana, and then with Salazzle, I don't know what I'm going to do with Salazzle here. Salazzle could just flamethrower the Feromosa. I could go for the X-Scissor on the, I'm going to go for, I suppose Feromosa is 4 times weak to flying, so I'm going to go for the Air Slash. I don't know why it's got Air Slash. It's like a physical attacker. But I'm going to give the Air Slash into the Feromosa. I'm just going to go offensive. I can't do much else. I suppose I could swap into Muk. I'm going to make a swap into Muk. I'm going to try my best not to keep putting my stylus over the screen. But I'm going to make a swap into Muk, predicting something hitting Salazzle. And then I've got to go for the Air Slash to try and do something to this Feromosa. Me being timid, I should outspeed. The Focus Blast! Oh, is that going for Katana? That's not going to do as much as oh my god, it killed me. Well, you know, I'm learning I'm probably not going to win this game. Oh, the Stone Edge from Necrozma. Oh my god, that did so much damage. You got a crit. That's stupid. Okay, so that's fine though. I am gonna go out into Minior, and I am gonna click Shell Smash for my life, and I'm gonna crunch to the Necrozma, and just hope he doesn't get any crit Stone Edges again. I think that's probably the best thing I can hope for right now. So I'm gonna go. Yeah, so I'm gonna go straight for the Shell Smash. And then with Muk, maybe we'll get that quick claw pop, and I'm going to go for the crunch onto the Necrozma. Feromosa, me first. Feromosa with the crunch onto Muk. That does too much damage. That does far too much damage. But that's not bad, though. I didn't actually see a point in that. It should have just gone for Focus Blast again. So I'm going to get all the stats under the sun. Muk will go for Crunch and hit Necrozma relatively hard. And then the crossbow's going to go for Stone Edge into Minior. Minior's going to survive that just about. So we're going to have a bit of a problem. So the Pheromosa now can just go for, like... Pheromosa can now just go for the me first when Minior attacks, which is terrifying. The explosion's like not gonna do anything. I'm gonna acrobatics Pheromosa, and I'm gonna crunch again the Krozma. But if he does play that, do that me first thing again, I'm in so much trouble. No Minior at speeds, gets the 4x super effective hit with a shell smash, and Pheromosa is going down. And then the Muk with a crunch. How am I outspeeding the Krozma? And Muk picks up the kill. Oh my god. This is ridiculous. This team is ridiculous. I thought I'd lost. Don't get me wrong, I still could lose, but they were the two main threats on the team. For me, anyway. And still got Salazzle in the back. I've got a Salazzle in the back. That Decidueye does not worry me. And there's a Seeking. Okay, so... I'm not going to be doing Explosion anytime soon, but I am going to go straight for the Acrobatics into the Decidueye slot. He could Sucker Punch. He could have Sucker Punch, but I should be able to live it, I would say. And then I'm going to go just for the Gunk Shot into the Seeking slot there. And I can't believe how much that turned it round. Like, I thought with Katana dead, Muk getting critted, like, turn one, that was it. That was going to be it. Muk with a Quick Claw popping as well, gets the Gunk Shot. When every Quick Claws, Gunk Shot always misses. But Acrobatics will destroy Decidueye, and it looks like I'm actually going to pick up a W in this game. Like, oh my god, Minior is going to go down to the Ice Beam, which, I mean, that's fair. Minior's put far too much work in these last couple of episodes, these last two episodes. So I'm going to go into Salazzle. I'm not overly confident yet, don't get me wrong, because, looking at my situation, I've got a fire type and a really, really weak poison type against a water. So I'm still, I'm still not going to say anything right now that I can win this. But I'm going to get the poison off on the Seeking, and I'm going to go for the Crunch. This is the biggest problem with the team. I've got Earthquake, but I need to start bringing Decidueye on my side too, so I can start using Explosion with Minior when there's a Decidueye there, because that'd be amazing. That did some serious damage, and now there's a Water Z move coming in, and to be fair, that's pretty terrifying. Not even gonna deny. Someone's taking a Hydro Vortex. Yep. Well, that's someone's going to be Salazzle. Yep. You probably wasn't living a waterfall, so yeah, it's... Like, Salazzle gets one useful thing in and then dies. So I'm in some serious trouble here now. Muk needs to, like, survive some hits now. So I could still lose this, potentially. Like, I'm on 27 health. If he lands a hit on me, that's it. So I feel I've got to go for Gunk Shot. It's my most powerful move. Muk, you can't miss this. Muk, you cannot miss this after this amazing battle has come down to the wire. This is so close, man. I mean, I'm hoping the residual damage from poison was the right play with Salazzle, because I could have gone for the Dragon Pulse, or well, it would have actually been Dragon Pulse, because I wasn't gonna Venom Shock. I was gonna Venom Shock the turn after, but I took a Hydro Vortex. My opponent's taking quite a long time to decide his turn here. Muk goes for Gunk Shot. The Gunk Shot lands. Will it be enough? Oh my god. The Seeking goes down. Muk pulls it out of the bag again. Oh my god, this Muk, man. That was the closest battle we've had so far. I mean, say, opening Necrozma and Pheromosa. And then, oh Jesus, it was that. I try and like put things down to when I feel like a game turned. It was that second turn when he went me first and then used Muck's Crunch. I didn't see a point in that. If he'd have Focus Blasted Mineor, no, I don't want to say that video. If he'd have Focus Blasted Mineor, then when the Mineor got hit again by the Necrozma, I think it was, Mineor would have gone down and probably not picked up as many kills. No, but yeah, that's fine. So we normally see how quick these are going to be. I'm going to try and keep these like two battles per episode, because it normally takes about 18 to 20, you know, 15 to 20 minutes per two battles. So we will see. But I am in love with this team, like absolutely. The amazing thing is, I know I'm on free battle spot, so when I go into rated, it's going to be a whole new ball game. I fully appreciate this, but my team's not even EV trained. But I'm assuming against other teams that aren't as well. This one, however, looks like it's a good one. We have got Torkoal, Oranguru, Porygon2, Marowak, Magearna, Decidueye. So this is a we are getting trick roomed hard in this game. So I need to think about stuff. I am not prepared to take Trick Room on. That's probably one thing where this team really lacks. So his Trick Roomers are Porygon2. He's got the Instruct combo, which I want to actually do. But Instruct Oranguru is really good anyway. I'm still gonna open Salazzle Katana, because I think I can near enough one shot anything he wants to bring out. And then I'm gonna bring Muk Toucan, because they're pretty slow Pokemon in themselves. But I think I need to come fast. I need to hit him hard out the bat. Yeah. And also, I've not really done much of the styling thing. I got a haircut and then didn't remove my hat. That's literally been my style in Sun and Moon so far, but eh. Doesn't bother me all that much. So I'm challenged. We have got Torkoal Oranguru. He's going straight out there. Oh, that's a shiny Torkoal. That's a beautiful Torkoal. So I'm going to Katana. Okay, so I feel like we're definitely going to get Eruption. If we're going to get Eruption, Instruct Eruption shenanigans happening in this game, then I feel I should like just go Detect with Katana. And then just go straight up for the Flamethrower in the sun, hitting the Oranguru. I feel it's the play when he could Shell Smash with the Torkoal. I don't know whether he'll be expecting me to protect myself with Katana. So we'll have to see. So I'm going to go for the Detect, and it's not like I'm focusing right now. I do apologize. Torkoal's going to Protect. That's amazing. Salazzle's going to get a Flamethrower off in the sun into that Oranguru slot, and it's going to do not as much as I think. And the Oranguru there with the Trick Room. Okay, that's fine. I mean, I didn't do enough turn one. I think I was a bit too scared. So now this is when I'm going to take the Eruption, and Katana is dead. I can't do anything about it, really, unless I go out and something else, but I don't want anything else taking this hit. I did mess that turn up. I literally came out with the idea I'm going to hit hard and fast, then I protected. I should have doubled down the Oranguru slot. That was a mistake. That was a mistake. But anyway, you live and learn. So I'm now going to double down the Oranguru slot, because why not? But we're going to have the Eruption from the Torkoal, and this is sick. Like, it just wrecked me. Like, and then Oranguru is gonna just come in with the Instruct. It's such a good strategy, that is. Like, Instruct Torkoal. I mean, I think when I saw Torkoal had the had Drought, I was like, really? Of all the Pokemon to give it to, Torkoal, and it's so good. It's like seriously so good. So I'm now left with Toucan and Muk, and I do think this is a loss. Like, 100%, I can't see me bringing this one back. He's got some sheer power in the back, and my sheer power just got erupted to death. So he's a pretty defensive monster, is Torkoal. So I'm gonna beat Blast. I'm gonna beat Blast, and I'm gonna go into the Oranguru. And then shall I try and target down the Oranguru? I'm gonna try and target down the Oranguru. Muck's not built for Trick Room either, because this is my in-game one, and it's an up-speed nature. So there's the Eruption, I'm full HP in the sun. That just destroyed both of my Pokemon. Like, Muck is alive. Just to see the Instruct. I just got swept by Instruct Torkoal. That is amazing. Absolutely amazing. I saw the team and I was like, that was probably going to be a loss, because that looked very, very, very good. Wow. Well, I think, you know, I said they take a while, but that one didn't. So I am going to have one more battle in this episode. That taught me a thing or two about how much I need that team. Okay, so I'm going to continue battling. Let's see what this comes up. Trick Room is, like, so big, like, right now. Trick Room is, like, the best, because so many Alola Pokemon are slow. But I really messed up that turn one. That's going to bug me, actually, that is. If I'd have just flamethrowed... I mean, flamethrowing the sun didn't do half, but if I'd flamethrowed, then X-Scissored onto the Oranguru. If I'd have killed the Oranguru, then it would have just made life so much easier for me. Because then all that I deal with, like, is one eruption a turn, not two. But, yeah, we have some brutalness there. Oh, this is going to take a while to find someone. It's going to be a dick. It's going to be a dick. Katana, though, fair play. Very impressed with it. Very impressed with Katana. I traded that for a Feromosa, which I got given on one of my live streams. But it's not a big thing. I was like, I've not actually got the Ultra Beast yet from this game, so. Oh, come on. Let's not do this. Oh well, as we've got a minute. If you have any team ideas, as I said before, if you've got any team ideas, leave sets, leave everything. If you want to leave them on, put them on Facebook, if you want to put them in the comment section below, I am good to do anything like that. So I'm going to go straight back into free battle. I'm good to, you know, look at teams and see what to do with them, because I want to just try all kind of different things. So I'm going to do, you can do Battle Spot Battle Royale. Okay, we might do that at some point. Special Pokemon allowed in doubles. Because I think it's, you know, it's the way people are playing VGC 2017. We'll confirm this team again. We have to go back out. So there is our beautiful team. Absolutely beautiful. I'm so happy with this team so far. Mux pulled so many games out of the bag. Katana, Salazzle. So, so good. Right, so let's hope we can find someone. But yeah, I just actually got off Ace Train to Phil. He traded me a Torkoal with Eruption, because it's an egg move. And he got one-on-one to trade, which was nice. And then I also got an Oranguru not long ago, so it's something I've got in the pipeline ready. I saw it on Cybertron. Cybertron did it. And I was like, yes, that's brutal. And he used for Torkoal. Okay, so we have a Japanese opponent here. With a team of Zygarde, Greninja, Solgaleo, Lunala, Primarina, and Necrozma. Right, so let's think about this. With Lunala being doubly weak to Dark, I think Muck is definitely here. Muck is definitely here, isn't he? Salazzle does some damage to a thingy, that thing. Solgaleo. I think I'll need Katana to maybe deal with maybe Greninja, and that could be the probably Battle Bond. Greninja, wait, it's Battle Bond. Greninja and Zygarde and Primarina, actually. So I'm thinking opening Muk. I'm thinking Muk, Katana, Salazzle, Mineor. The only reason I'm thinking Mineor is because if we get a Shell Smash off, I can just try and win late game, do an explosion, or just hit hard with acrobatics after I've white herbed. So I think I'm giving Muk a chance in the limelight because if he opens Luna, if he opens Solgaleo Lunala, not only will that look amazing on my video, I've got an answer, potentially got an answer for both of them. So let's do this. This is my first full legendary battle. I need to do more of these. I need to do more of these. Okay. Zygarde, Greninja. So I'm gonna open Katana and Muk, and he is going to be looking for that cheap kill to get a Battle Bond boost. So I could straight away I can minimize with Muk and detect with Toucan, giving Zygarde a chance to Dragon Dance, Zygarde a chance to Coil. So many things I could do there. So I might go straight for the Gunk Shot with Muk, and I'm going to hit Greninja. And then I am going to. You know what? I'm going to target down Greninja. I'm going to go for Leaf Blade into the Greninja slot as well, because I'm not. I don't want to deal with I don't want to deal with Battle Bond Greninja. I really don't. Okay, he's got Hydro Cannon, and Muk takes that like a champ. Is he Choice Scarfed? Because that seems a bit ridiculous. But Greninja is going to go down, and then a Gunk Shot is going to go into the face of Zygarde, and Zygarde goes for Thousand Arrows, and I think Muk is there. Oh no, they pits both. So Muk's definitely dead to the Thousand Arrows. So Thousand Arrows being a ground type move is a big problem for my team. I think this is when I'm probably going to go into Mineon and try and get that Shell Smash off. And he goes into Solgaleo. All right, so I'm slightly worried about this thing, obviously. But Mineor's got some pedigree. Mineor can survive some hits. Being Flying Rock, I think a Sunsteel Strike is going to hit him. If he can live one Sunsteel Strike, then I reckon we're fine. I'm going to go straight for the Leaf Blade into the Zygarde and try to set up a Shell Smash over here. That does some serious damage as Thousand Arrows hits. Not gonna affect. Oh wow. Is it a dragon move? Might be a dragon move. The Flare Blitz is going to make sure Katana never comes back till next episode. And then the Shell Smash is gonna go, and I'm gonna be faster than both of these Pokemon. And then, oh man, this is close now. So it being the problem now, both Salazzle can now come in. I don't feel bad about this situation now, because I didn't expect. I really thought Sunsteel Strike was there, and but now when your problems get that little bit bigger. I totally forgot he could do that. Oh man, we have a perfect Zygarde on the field. Okay, so I'm gonna go into Salazzle. And look how. I mean, my opponent's side of the field right now is pretty damn imposing. Like, I got a lizard and a floating rock. I'm gonna go for the acrobatics. And I'm gonna go into the Zygarde. I am then going to go for the flamethrower, and I'm going to go in. I could target down the Zygarde, or I mean, I could Dragon Pulse into the Zygarde, but he's only got, but I'm no. I'm going to go for Solgaleo because I think I need to try and split this around a bit. Okay, so the acrobatics is going to hit the Zygarde for some very good damage, and then Salazzle's going to get a flamethrower off into Solgaleo. Oh, that's a 2-hit KO-ish. But there's a Sunsteel Strike. I mean, it's gonna happen. That's probably what was gonna lose me this game, because Mineor is not taking this. Like, no way. And I expected that to come. But now, obviously, Thousand Arrows are going to come in and do some serious damage to Salazzle. And, yeah, that's going to be the game. That is going to be the game. Well played. I mean, your team was so strong. I could only do what I could. I could only play how I could. And, yeah. What can I say? I was happy. I was happy with how I played in that game. But I think that's good enough time as any. We've had, you know, had three battles in this episode. I won one of them. It was alright. It was alright. Thank you very much for watching, guys. This is so much fun. I'm loving this. Whether I'll bring the same team to episode 3 or a new team, I couldn't tell you right now. But I'll tweak it a bit. I'll bring different Pokemon. You might see the same. And I haven't actually used Decidueye in this, and I only used 2 cannon in the one game. So we'll see if there's more action from that, more like Decidueye with Minior and Explosion with Ghost, fun and Z-move stuff. So until then, guys, please leave a like on this video, subscribe if you are new, follow me on my social media, and I will see you guys in the next video. Thank you very much, guys. See you soon. Bye-bye.